Welcome to the Writer's Rendezvous from the South Dakota Humanities Council.
Hello, I'm Carl Gerke of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, and we're coming to you from the Deadwood Mountain Grand for the 2013 South Dakota Festival of Books. And with me is the wonderful novelist Pete Dexter. His books include Deadwood, Paris Trout, and Spooner. Pete, thanks so much for joining us.
Well, thanks for having me over.
Now, this isn't, you've been to a number of these book festivals, haven't you?
I missed the first one, and I think, and I can't remember, I got bit by a dog about 3 years ago. I was in the hospital with it for 10 weeks. Almost died, and I was down to 120 pounds. And I can't remember if that year I was well enough to do it or not. But if I didn't miss it that year, I haven't missed any.
You were bitten by a dog? A serious bite.
Well, it really wasn't. It was a puppy bit me. It was my daughter's dog. But maybe 7 or 8 days went by, and suddenly it just, boy, it hit like that. And next thing I knew, we were in an ambulance to Phoenix, which is a long ways from, it's 150 miles, and just almost didn't make it. And really, infection was everywhere. So be careful, brush your dog's teeth out there.
Wow. Not your first, I don't know, near death experience is the right term, but you're no stranger to hospitals.
No, that's true. But I'll tell you, in a lot of ways, that was the worst one. It was certainly the worst I've ever been treated in a hospital there in Phoenix. I mean,
the way you were treated.
Yeah, I mean, it's a miracle I got out of there alive. I had no idea. You hear this stuff about hospitals and how people die there just from ill treatment. But, I mean, I had people come in and I had a nurse come in and throw a glass of water in my face when I was so sick I couldn't even move. And I had, name calling and stuff. It was just like the worst. Stuff went on in that hospital that if anybody had been able to document it, you could come work for the hospital because I'd own one. Not that you'd want to.
So does an experience like that, does it translate into your writing at all, or is that just an unpleasant experience and you just as soon forget about it?
Well, I would just as soon, I'd love to forget about it. That doesn't happen when you know, there are things happen to you that you can't walk away from completely, even though you physically walk away from it. And that's one of those. And I mean, I will promise you it'll find its way into something I write without my, I'm not going to go aim to do it. But it will find its way in. It always does. And obviously that's where a writer's stuff comes from, is what happens to him, what he sees. And that's where most of it comes from anyway. And something that profound is just there at the door all the time, knocking to get in. And if you give into it, I guess it's all right to use it once, but if it keeps coming back and you keep kind of finding yourself revisiting that area, then you got to go back and do a lot of cutting. And you're thinking about it too much. So far in my life, I'm not in control of what comes in or what goes out.
So you're constantly surprised at what comes out on the paper, on the page?
Oh, on a good day, I'm surprised. It always feels lucky. It always does. And on days when it doesn't come as, more than I used to be, I get bitterly disappointed on days when I'm not happy with what came out. And I suppose that's because I've got four books going right now at the same time. It's just crazy. Three of them are related in that some of the same characters go through all three of them. And then the fourth one is one day about mid-May. There's no J month.
No.
Mid-J.
June, July.
Yes. I couldn't figure out which one of these three books one day I came in there. I couldn't figure out where I wanted to work for the next month or two. And so I just started writing, and then another book started. And that's about 140 pages now. And so they're all sitting there in some half done, probably all of them. And I can't remember how I got on this subject, but I would, if there are aspiring young writers out there, and there don't seem to be very many aspiring young readers. Have you seen this crowd, by the way?
No. I've been in here.
Well, the average age out there is like 119, and it's good. I mean, yeah, I'm glad that people still read and are able to read into their dotage, but there's no kids out there. I mean, what do they get? And my daughter, who's a kid to me, she's 30, but a little older, but she reads, her husband reads, her fiance reads, my wife reads, but kids-wise, it's just something that they don't do anymore, or don't seem to. I mean, maybe when they go to college, they have to.
Well, I've got nieces and nephews that are, in the early teen years, late teens, and they just plow through books. In one book, they got the next one. I don't know if it's...
Well, that's good news. Yeah. Are they girls or boys?
Girls and boys. They both just plow through. They're at that young adult age. They're reading that young adult fiction, and they just... whether that will translate to being readers on, I don't know. But at this age, they're always with books.
You ought to talk to my sister. Kitty Martin is her name. She wrote 6 or 7 young adult novels, and then stopped doing it for some reason. But boy, they were really. I guess the point being, I mean, Kitty's every bit as good a writer as I am, and probably I've been Kitty Dexter's little brother all my life, and I probably still am. And if you put our prose down side by side, I'm not sure that she's not the better writer. And all this stuff went into these clean, brisk, penetrating sentences went into these books that are written for 12 and 13 and 11-year-olds. And I read those and realized that it's not just, I mean, they're for younger people, but the writing in it, the things that some kid might fall in love with or want to be a writer himself, in the good ones, in good young adult or whatever you call that genre, in those books, the writing is just as good as it is in most of the fiction you'll find out there on the floor. And in her case, it's a lot better than, I mean, you'd be amazed at how, maybe you wouldn't be amazed, but I'm always amazed at how good that stuff is.
Do you ever have had any interest in writing that kind of young adult fiction?
No. I don't think I'm quite connected enough to it all happened too long ago for me to even remember what it's like. It's out there just a little beyond the horizon. I go out about
right there
about 7 years and then it all's a blur.
Well, Pete, thanks so much for taking the time to talk with us.
Listen, thanks for having me in.
Writer's Rendezvous is a production of SDPB.